have a look at. I'm just gonna pick a random one. Have you got any funny touring moments? So that could be whether within whatever, like whoever.
Okay. Funny touring moments. It's always fun, like when someone gets on the stage with us. You know, like during, like, do you remember when we used to do, what song was it? It was Virgin Sexy going into Nasty Ghetto. And on tour, we would have these like massive beds and we would choose a guy from the audience and we would tie them up with the handcuffs. Uh-huh. And now, I just feel like, obviously when you're younger, you have like a lot more like confidence, but like,
yeah,
I literally remember like us like tying them up and like riding them, like, and I always found that quite funny. Yeah. I feel like that tour for me was like, just because it had all the props and everything else, it was so much fun. But yeah, I feel like that's a tour moment.
Yeah, fine.
Right, my turn.
Okay, go on.
Okay, so I got some for you, trust me. Let me just pick in them, and I'm a Libra, so you know this could take all day. Right. Okay, so
are you up?
Okay, let me start easy. What's your favorite Sugababes song?
Oh, okay, favorite Sugababes song. Yeah. What is that? Once was released or not?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh my god.
Pause right there, 1 second, Mutya.
Yeah.
You see that person online pretending to be Heidi? You're throwing shade, but she actually wouldn't say that, so.
Throwing shade at us.
Yeah.
Okay, it's okay. Bye.
But she wouldn't even say that to us anyway, so.
She wouldn't, because there's nothing, yeah, all right.
She would never even say that, but okay, go on.
It's fine, we'll just get
go on, babe. What's your favorite show?
Do you know what? Hole in the Head, I really liked for some reason. Ooh, but I think I just like the video.
Really?
I don't know, maybe because it was quite fun. So I hate it when we performed it so many times, I think I really hate it. But when I listen to it, like, you know, so often, then it makes, it sounds all right. I don't know.
Not as a
vocal song.
Yeah, that was actually probably one of my favorites that we've done with Brian.
Yeah.
It's one of the favorites. Yeah.
I don't know. What about you anyway?
Well, what's my... Oh, you're giving me the same question. Okay. Yeah. I think for me, it was mostly... I enjoyed more the album tracks than anything else.
I think that's me too.
Do you know what I mean? I felt like the main singles were like more poppier than the album tracks. Right. I think Shape of My Heart is something where if someone hadn't heard of the Sugababes before, I would be like, oh, you know, like, this is what we did, and I'd probably play that one, so.
No, that's true, actually, to be honest. Yeah. All right, fine. All right, I need to give you something juicy. I think we should just get straight into it.
All right, come on then.
The goody-goody. Okay, wait,
what? Maybe laugh.
One second. Hello?
I remember being in the tattoo parlor, and I was like, yeah, I'm going to get the name. And then he weren't that excited. Like, I didn't really feel the vibe that he was going to get my name. So I was like, nah. So I ended up getting Just Love instead.
Glad you didn't get his name.
And then, as you know, I got the cross. But did the cross was like...
I remember that one.
Yeah, they did it like almost like the Antichrist. So I started freaking out and I had to get God's grace the next day.
Because it looks upside down.
It looks upside down. So I got God's grace at the bottom because I was like, nah. Yeah. Anyway. So, right, let me see. Okay, so I want to know, Mutya.
Yeah.
If you could have two other members outside of me and Siobhan to be in the Sugababes with you on stage, who would it be? Who would it be, girl?
Where did you find this question from?
In my head.
So, if it's besides from you and Siobhan, right?
Yeah, it could be anyone you want.
What do you mean? Are you talking about as the other Sugababes? The other girls? Or are you talking about
anyone? Any of your favorite singers?
Oh, okay. Janae, and Kalani.
Oh, okay. No one.
I thought that there was like the Summer Walker, actually. Yeah, no, let me
change. Oh, you do like Summer Walker.
I love Summer Walker.
Mm. Yeah.
But you know what? I actually thought, Keisha, I thought that was going to be a trick question. I thought you were trying to ask me. Who else do I want to be in a group with if it wasn't you and Siobhan? That's us thinking, what am I meant to be treated from the other girls? That's after I love it. Anywho.
Oh, it's your turn.
Well, right, what's this? Okay. Nadine's, wait, I love Nadine. I think Nadine's like, she's got a wicked voice as well. I know, right? I'm trying to pick that.
Next question.
All right, next question. Right, what is your least Sugababes favorite? Oh no, favorite. What's your least Sugababes song? To hate my that, least... that you sing live, like singing live.
Oh, my least favorite.
Singing live.
Sugababes song.
Yeah.
Would be. I'm not sorry. let me keep it 100. Yeah.
Give it to them, yeah.
The very, 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 very last Sugababes album that I was on. If I actually released that, I would say that was the most. And it has nothing to do with the girls, yeah. But just in general, like we didn't write on that album. Just everything about it was just. To say it's no, horrendous, say a bit traumatic.
That one, so thanks.
No, it was just, yeah, and it's not even to do with the girls. It was just, it was all, like, musically, it just wasn't, great. Right. So,
what is it? Cool.
All right, I would say, okay.
Sorry.
What's going on? I would say, I'm not that cool on Red Dress and In the Middle.
In the Middle?
I like the video. Actually, okay. You know what? No, let's just say Red Dress. Let me just say Red Dress. But like I said, if
in the Red Dress.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. I just but
yeah,
it wasn't
I agree on Red Dress, to be honest. Album. I mean, I actually never got a chance to sing Red Dress live. But I would agree that would be absolutely my the song that I would choose that I would have hated to sing live.
Mm. Oh, Yasmin! Hi, Yasmin!
So I kind of got out of it at great timing, to be honest.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Right.
Is it my turn, yeah?
Yep, it's your turn.
All right, cool. So, okay. How do you feel about the way you and I, or the way that we've been, or you've been represented, like, media-wise throughout the years of Sugababes? Do you feel like, for yourself, like, do you feel that it was accurate? Do you feel like you were a part of the narrative?
Or
how did you feel about it back then and today?
Right, so I feel like, I mean, people have got more to say these days because of the social media. You can speak loud about, you know, situations. I feel like back then when there wasn't a lot of social media going around and things were being spoken about us individually that were wrong, we never ever had a chance to put it out there. And I think people looked at it, especially with myself, because I get a lot of different types of feelings towards me. I think some people don't know how to take them. Some people think, I don't know. At one point, I feel like I was getting a bit bullied by the press. Years ago, where they would constantly write about stupid shit that really didn't mean anything. Mm-hmm. And just trying, and obviously when you ain't got no words to say, do you know what I mean? You can't even say, oh, they're lying. And everyone has to just take their words for it. But I'm happy to say that I've seen people realize that a lot of newspapers chat shit. So I think today's way of like maybe talking about situations that were true or not true, I think this is the best way to go through it.
Yeah.
So thank God for live, we can now think about our own stuff.
Yeah, for sure. But also as well, I feel like, for you, I mean, obviously I saw a lot of stuff that you went through. Mm. And I think when you were in the band with me, I feel like I was able to like share it a little bit because really they would more so talk about like, they would talk about my character
mm-hmm.
and they would talk about maybe like your image.
Yeah.
Which I feel like sometimes even without meeting us would, I didn't see it at the time. I definitely feel like it was a racial thing. And you know, yeah. I don't even really speak about things like that.
Yeah.
But I see it now because of social media and I'm like, oh my God, all of these issues that are like on the forefront for everyone to sort of like see. And when you look at this, I look back and, you know, my mum's kept everything, like all the magazines and everything. Oh my God, and I look at just the way that we were like described, like the wording around it, you know, it'd be terrible. Like, you know, feisty Mutya and you know, Keisha attitude.
But
they would always describe you and me as that. And then the white girl would always be like the fair hair, the softer, the character of how that they would do that. I feel like it would be very, very unfair. And when you were in the group with me, I felt like, you know, I was able to like share some of those experiences. So I felt like, okay, even though I'm being like judged so badly, you know, at least she's with me. But then when you left, I was like, I literally would get like, I would get it like on my own. So that like was really hard. What a lot of people don't know actually is that behind the scenes, there was kind of like a lot of support for us not to say anything. Yeah. Do you remember, we'd always be told like, it'll be tomorrow's chip paper, don't worry about it. But we would never encourage, if there was a rumor like that we had this massive fight, it would be like either me starting it or you starting it. We would be like,
it's the norm.
Yeah, and we would be like, oh, this, and they were like, just ignore it. We know the truth, including other members of the group. And we would be like, okay, we've got their support. In front of interviews, they'd be like, ask us a question. And we'd be like, now everyone go and stand up for us. And they'd be like,
I know. But you know what? That's the thing of it all now is that we're grown women and we can speak free and out loud. And that's what it says. I'm sure there's a whole bag of people right now trying. If they could shush us right now, be like, they would have done that. Because people don't like the truth, innit? And that's why I'm glad that we can actually talk these things without, and put people to rest with it as well.
Yeah.
We get asked
and the support. What I love is that our fans, and I'm not actually just saying this because you guys are down there, but the support that you've given us, like you guys to support us, like majorly. I can actually see in the comments, quite a few times people have been asking about, remember that picture of, you weren't in the group then, but there's this picture of me and Paul Demain.
Oh yeah.
And I think we were on the set of About You Now, and they've got me like talking to him. But you know, I'm very animated.
Right.
Like in real life. Like that. But Pat caught me and it looked mad. Like I was going like in his, no matter how many times I say like, I love Paul. We were literally just talking like the other day. Like no matter how many times I say that and that actually wasn't what it looks like, that's the way it was framed. And it's just like, I guess that's just what comes with the territory of, you know. But thanks for everyone who has supported us and who didn't judge us. And your turn.
Yeah,
there, everyone. Okay, so for me, I like creativity. I like someone who is creative and, like, for example, you don't have to like spend, like I've dated guys who like will just like send you to the most expensive place or whatever and then you don't have a connection. I'm good with like someone remembering my favorite movie, putting it on, getting all my favorite snacks.
Yes.
You know, like I'm good with that. Like I feel like that is, I like romance more than anything else. So anything that is, he's listened to it and he's, you know, he's doing basically what I've said that I like. Anything like that, I'm good with. Not anything specific.
Oh, wow, that's good. To be honest, I'm not fussy at all. Okay.
You're not.
I'm not fussy.
I want you to be more fussy in 2020. Well, I judge that, guys.
Well, 2020. The only thing I can do right about now is get fussy in 2020 because I have to sit down
get fussy.
And think.
get fussy because, you know, some of the men you choose are questionable. You know, your girl over here, she won't like
them. I know.
Okay. Now this one here. This was from Instagram. What's your favorite Disney movie?
Oh my God. All right. So Lady and the Tramp, I think, is my favorite.
Okay.
No, we only had that 2020 or even whatever. So Lady and the Tramp is my favorite. They've actually redone a new version of it, which I find really irritating. because I just prefer the actual cartoon film with no humans in it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I think we talked about this the other day. I said Beauty and the Beast, but yes. I actually like the new version
you
as well.
Do.
I'm
no.
good with that.
No, I can't do the new one. Sorry. The new one, it's just humans. I don't like the fact that they've got human beings in it. Do you know what I mean?
No, that's what gets me. This is what gives me pure joy. Love it. I love it a lot. I do.
I love it a lot.
Yeah. Okay, so.
Yes. Give me some.
What gets you through hard times? When you've gone through hard times, what gets you through those times?
Oh my God. Having a good support system is always great. Do you know what? As long as I've got my weed and I've got music, I think I'll be all right. That kind of gets me through my days, actually.
Yeah,
it does. I think it just relaxes me. My head goes like a million miles per hour, so I need something to pull me back and just chill me out. So I'll
do it. Do you like listen to anything? Like, does music help at all? Or
listening to music helps. That.
But it's like, my weed, I gotta get my weed.
It's true. So I can't lie though, the new Janae, her new album is perfect for like any weed smokers. It's so chill out and relaxed.
Every
like,
album.
The noises from all over. Every album, but up in this one, which has got them like, I don't know what it is. I watched a video of her the other day, she's got it where she does like that to the drums.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you know who does that? Yasmin. I don't know if Yasmin's still watching this, but Yasmin Evans, she is it like burning the sage and all that kind of stuff?
Baz, yeah, I have to burn a bit of sage as well sometimes, yeah.
Yeah.
It helps, it calms you down.
Yeah?
Yeah, but
is it your turn?
Yes, it is my turn. Okay. Right, let's have a look. Right. What's your favorite alcoholic drink?
Malibu and pineapple.
Always. So we told the story about your Malibu and pineapple story the other day, didn't we? But for anyone that's in here, Keisha has like the best imagination when it comes to when she has a drink. I swear to God, everything just all comes. The creativity starts flowing in place, and that's how we come up with lay down swimming pools, right?
Yeah, so the trick, so basically I don't drink, right? But I basically have a very strong desire for Malibu and pineapple, but I think it's because it tastes like juice.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what happened that day, but everyone was smoking weed in the room. I don't smoke, but the fumes maybe?
Yeah, I think it might have got a bit higher for it,
Maybe that with the Malibu and pineapple. But yeah, when I'm chill, when I'm relaxed, then there's no pressure. I definitely feel like I get a lot more creative, as do you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Mutya, I've never asked you this before, but who is your best friend?
My best friend?
Malibu and pineapple.
Oh my God, are you drinking Malibu and pineapple? Wait.
Red wine.
Listen, don't play games with me, you know. I bought a bottle of wine today. Oh, can I tell you the scariest thing happened to me, guys? So, I went to the shop about 6 o'clock, yeah? Well, I'm just going to go and get an ice cream. So, anyway, I've never seen... There's no females outside. I just saw one dude in the corner, standing in the corner, going, hello, hello, trying to talk to me. I'm like, no, excuse me. He's like, yes. I'm like, no. He's like, yes. Trying to like be really aggressive, just standing in the corner randomly, and then little boys on their little scooters running around the whole place. Listen, it's scary out there for females. Be careful. I'm telling you, absolutely be careful, because I was seeing some weirdos just standing in the corner of my road. That is, it's mental out there. Trust me. Don't trust no one. But people trying to take things off people as well, which I heard. Just be careful. I need to get poor me a drink, because that just seems like the right thing to do.
Wait, is it your question or mine?
Well, I did ask you a question.
Oh, I did that. That was in Malibu.
Okay.
Oh no, I did ask you a question. Who's your best friend?
Oh, I said I don't have one.
Oh, you don't have one? Oh, okay.
I don't have one. You know what? I'm right back now. I'm isolated from everybody.
Okay, you know what? Fine.
I don't have one yet. I mean, to be honest, I've got close friends. I wouldn't say best, but I've got close people that are just family to me.
Yeah, it changes, doesn't it? It changes as you get older.
It does change a lot. It changes a lot because everyone has their own, you know, everyone grows into different people. Mm. I mean, you know? I could thank God, actually, because he's the only person that listens to me at night time because I moan a lot.
He likes a moaner. He loves every kind of...
Definitely.
Rude your end, lovey. So, tell me, what are your favourite things and least favourite things about me?
About me?
Yeah, I mean, you've known me for 100 years, so I'm sure you can.
Right, yeah, true, actually. Right.
So, what's your least favourite?
You're very positive, and you always help a situation. So, like, I remember, like, there's been so many times when I just needed that push, and you're always great at, like, just, you know, making things so much better.
Thank you.
No, of course. And, I can't think of anything. Like, let me have a look. I've got to think about this one. Let me think. I can't think of anything bad. Everything's always trying to be positive. Do you know what I mean? Like, I try not to think about any negative stuff. I think that's when you start going into, like, I think everything's been pretty positive.
Yeah.
And I think the older we've gotten as well has become even better because we've all become closer and we can talk more freely. Whereas friends, I think before when we were younger, we had all different friends and a lot of people always, and now lots of people always come between us. So I think now we get to actually speak and, you know, so it's nicer.
No, I do. Sorry, I am listening.
Well, you're reading all that. Are you reading?
No, I cannot. You're trying to see me settle down, yeah? I want to see you settle down first. How about that? Because I have watched you on Love & Hip Hop.
Oh, right. Yeah.
And I've known you for a while, and I'm yet to see one woman.
That's
nice, Mutya. I think I'm going to answer it for you. So I feel like my favorite thing about you is your heart. Like, you truly are a really sweet person. You're a really, really sweet person. I feel like you are a really giving person. If I needed something, I feel like I could ask you. Do you know what I mean?
Definitely.
I wouldn't feel away. Like, yeah. Amy, you said you can think of the least favorite, but I can't.
You can. You know what? The worst thing about it is, I could actually think of a bag of shit by myself. You know, I couldn't think about.
My least favorite thing is that sometimes I feel like, your focus could be a little bit more.
Yeah, my focus is bad though.
I feel like you could be a little bit more life focused. And I feel like if you are, I feel like you would definitely, you know, soar for sure.
Yeah, you know what? You're right. Because I can think of a bag of things. I saw my sister as well putting up their hand. Dory, I am such a Dory as well. Forgetful.
Yeah.
I am a Dory. But no, I don't focus enough, I think.
Yeah.
My focus is really bad. What's your best moment with a fan, someone asked?
Best moment with, I think anytime I get, do you know what? Let's take it back. 2009 was a really, trying year for me. A lot of things changed in my life. And I feel like one of the things that got me through into 2010 and onwards was actually a lot of the DMs that I would get from the fans.
But I agree.
sometimes you'll be having a mad day and then someone will send you a random message and you look and you think, oh my gosh, like it was, I've done all of this for a reason. And I think kind of selfishly, when you're young and you're getting into this game, you kind of think, you know, I want to sing, I love writing, I like singing live, I'm with my friends from school,
whatever.
And so you kind of just like, you're more self-driven as a kid. But you don't realize how many lives you touch. Like to this day, I get like, so like when people go, oh, we grew up with you, I'm like, oh my gosh, like it makes me really proud, you know? And it you know, I feel like having that feedback has been some of my favorite moments, just hearing, you know, that we did something, we made changes, and it literally, people think that like we inspire them, but I know from like they inspire
it's
us
that,
also. They truly, truly do, they help us out, like we'll be having some down days and like, whoosh, those messages.
I totally, totally agree. Like I can't, yeah, that for me.
Yeah.
The fans do bring me up a lot, I can't lie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, okay. Mutya.
Yes?
I want you to tell all of these people.
Yeah. Oh God.
Why? I don't follow you on Instagram. Go on, name and shame yourself. Tell them why.
Okay, you told me this the other day. Wait, what was it again?
You know why I don't follow you on Instagram. And now I'm being stubborn because, but what's the reason why I don't follow you on Instagram? You know that, why are you pausing?
No, wait, is it because,
I never messaged
you back.
Okay, so guys, Mutya, you don't even say anything right now. I know that everyone out there
will
know
that
there is someone in their life. In fact, you're not the only person too. There's two other friends as well. Where basically, no. I'll message them and I'll be like, oh yeah. And they will not message back. And then you'll see them on live. So in order for me not to like be in my feelings and be all like hurt about it. And you know what? It wasn't the third friend. Let me not lie. It was my brother. And I had to unfollow him. And he hasn't gotten a follow back yet. Because he did the same thing. So, and you know, I was going to follow you back, and then one of the fans were like, you don't follow Mutya, blah, blah. And I was like, you know what? Now I'm in my feelings again. You ain't going to tell me who I should follow.
See, that's not nice. That's not nice. It's actually
very good. No, it is nice. You know what? You should be ignoring people's calls, and then clearly you're on your phone.
No.
You're on your phone.
Tell the truth now, Keisha. Tell the truth. I have been good recently, man.
You know what? We are in March, and I will say, for the last 3 months, let's ignore 2016, 17, 18,
19.
But you know what? No. But you've been good. You've been good for the last 3 months. Yeah. Now you've been better.
I can't live alone.
So actually, I should follow you today because of that, for sure.
I think you get. Thank you, everyone. Tell her to follow me back because I think
I'm going to follow you now, but I'm going to put a pre-warning there. I'll follow my brother back actually because he has gotten back to me. But I'm letting you both know and the other friend. So if you guys ignore me and I see you on Instagram again, unfollowed again, and I will feel no shame. Okay.
No,
I love you, but
yeah, I'm telling you, like, just follow me in it.
Alright. Go on, your turn.
So I'll give you a piece of paper, please. Okay, why don't you stay there? Give me 2 seconds. I've got to make a quick phone call. Stay there.
What?
So 2 seconds.
What kind of live is this? So while Mutya's gone, what else? Let me see. What's the hardest decision you had to make in your career? Ooh. I haven't really had to make any yet. I can see everyone talking about how many drinks. So the other day, I feel like I've got a big mouth and I was like,
if you guys want me to drop that video, because we recorded it.
You should, you know.
Yeah, how many drinks?
Who?
But I just have to wait. Like, let me just speak to, I have to speak to Siobhan, see if that's okay as well. So let's just, you know, we'll see. My favorite song from One Touch is One Touch and Promises. You need to come back before you hit us off.
Sorry, I need to. Do you know I need to go to the shop? That's
like. Okay. Well, do you know what?
No, I'm not going right now.
Do you know what? Can you give me some attention? Guys, comment below and say focus. Just say it over and over again to her. Focus. Right, we've got 10 more minutes before we have to come on. Now, or less even. Okay, so.
Oh, it's my turn.
It's your turn. Oh,
right,
yeah, go ahead.
My turn. Right. What's your favorite clothes shop? Like, what's your favorite? Okay, so designer and streetwear.
Okay, so I love anything by Acne. Okay, I'm done with you. David Comer. I like anything else on the wag. I like. I'm done with your holiday ring.
Sorry. Hello.
I like 5785. Guys, remember when I said focus? Remember when I said my least favorite thing about Mutya focus? Can you see what I mean? Okay. I don't tell no lies, you know.
Yeah.
Anything I say, I bring receipts. Look.
Sorry, I'm here.
Are you done?
I'm here.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
You want to go paint your toenails for a while?
No. I'm good. Focus.
Yeah, and then my favorite high street shops are like Topshop. Topshop.
Topshop. I prefer River Island, I think.
Oh yeah, I like as long as it's mixed. I will mix. I'm very big on high street and designer. Mix the two together,
right,
and you're in.
I don't really know about. The other one that you just said, I've not heard about them before.
I'll send you some stuff.
Okay, fine. Perfect.
Okay, now, I've asked. Oh wow, I'm caning through these. Okay.
Zara's good.
Ooh.
Yeah. I quite like Zara actually. Saying that.
Oh, Zara's. The thing is, Zara. I've only in the last few months liked Zara because
I used to think Zara was older.
Yeah, but it's actually nice now. Also as well, do you know what? ASOS have been really good to us. They've sent us lots of stuff. Shout out to ASOS.
Yeah.
I love mix and matching their stuff too. Yeah. Misguided's
great as well.
Pretty Little Thing is everything. I swear that I remember when Pretty Little Thing first came out and I was like, I really felt like I discovered it. I was just like, yes, there's this thing, and everyone would be asking me where I got it from, and I was like, oh, it's just, you know, this like expensive wayline. I'll send a picture. Okay. Oh my god, do I want to get. Oh, have you ever dated anyone famous, Mutya?
No, I haven't actually. Not that I can think of. No. Why are you looking at me like that for?
No, I'm just gone.
I don't know. Was anyone famous? I can't. Maybe not dated anyone famous. Well, I don't know. No, I don't know. I can't think of no one.
Okay.
But maybe you can have to tell me or remind you if there was someone, but I can't remember.
So you give me one last question and I'm going to give you one last question.
I got you. Right. So, what's your opinion on the coronavirus right now? What's going on?
Well, I mean, are we in Armageddon? I don't know.
I mean, to be honest,
at this point, do you know what it is? I cannot believe that we're in 2020 and we're not prepared for these things.
Mm-hmm.
I think that there needs to, I always like to see the light at the end of the tunnel. So I'm hoping that through this situation, there will be more investments, more money put into science and medicine so that we can avoid these things. I mean, I don't even know if you can even avoid them, but there needs to be, it's crazy that this is like sweet, like the earth this way. I feel really bad for people who have got like grandparents who are, you know, living with them. They're putting them at risk by even going to work every day, like, because they have to. I worry about people actually who are in a situation where they're like, no, for real, how am I going to pay my rent?
Yeah.
And I feel like, you know, this has to be a wake-up call that we all have to, like,
Exactly.
The hierarchies need to like really step it up. And I'm also as well just encouraging everyone out there that we just need to do a lot to help each other right now. So find out your local food banks. I know there's one in Collinsdale as well, where they're actually really low on supplies at the moment. And just really think about other people, and you know, you don't need to buy 4 toilet rolls. Like you Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? So
the toilet roll price is somewhat goodness me.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. It's sad out there though, but everyone needs to stick together.
Stick together. Oh my god, you've asked me that question and now I just feel like the questions that I have in the last one is a little bit like okay. Yo. Okay. Who was your I'm not going to say least favorite. Who is your favorite member to join? So we're not talking about the originals. We're not talking about Siobhan. We're not talking about me. We're talking about any replacements. Who would be your favorite replacement in the
From the other three girls?
I'm being a bit controversial, but who is your favorite replacement? We're not talking about least favorite. Favorite. This is easy for me. I mean, I don't know why.
Well, I'd say hi, dude.
I mean, high five me.
Oh, yeah, definitely Heidi. You would have to be.
Let me say something.
To be honest.
For sure.
It would make sense anyway.
I mean, exactly.
I wouldn't. You know, the thing about it is, I think Heidi spent a lot of time in the Sugababes. So I can't. There's no way you can disrespect that fact.
That's why it's a no-brainer. And to be fair, and I think a lot of people feel like, oh, you know, the originals and all that, and actually there is like it on our side anyway, there is no beef, it's nothing like that. At the end of the day, we know what made the Sugababes and we definitely respect, you know, her time with us.
We spent a lot of time together, so to be honest, it would only be wrong if I had to sit and say someone else. So to be honest, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, for sure.
It was fun times, guys.
But what are you doing for the rest of the evening?
I'm just gonna have a party to myself.
Nice. I'm gonna sit here.
I'm gonna open up the bottle of wine and just chill.
Nice. Well, enjoy. What are you doing? Well, I'm gonna eat some crisps. I'm really trying because you know my knees are like, I had an MRI scan. It's a joke, so I can't even run or anything.
Right.
So I'm just trying really hard.
No. I'm gonna go get some popcorn now actually, because I've got to go shop anyway.
Yeah.
Popcorn glasses. I think I've got a couple of packets still left. Maybe. We'll see.
Okay.
All right. I'm gonna message you.
Say.
No, I love everyone. Stay safe. Stay in your houses. Don't go out.
See you guys later. Love you. Bye, guys.